Nice.
You decided to join me. Like I said last night, we're going to head out to the Curtis Glacier, which is a cirque glacier on Mount Shuckson. Avalanche fed, heavily avalanche fed. So it's got real steep walls around it. And it sits at about 5,400 feet. I got Irina here, somewhere that way. And we're gonna go do a investigatory adventure here. Thanks for coming.
Yeah, they've been around for a long time. Those trees right there, we're what, probably at 4,800 feet, maybe a little higher. Those trees could range from 500 to 700 years old. Howdy.
Hey.
Oh, there you are. Hey, there's Baker over there. So we're a little over halfway. About to break over to Lake Ann over this pass. Whoa. Just around the corner here is the glacier. In all its glory.
Hey friends, how are you doing?
This is actually something that's pretty interesting too, that you can see from here. Pretty good vantage point of it. You can see the different layers. If you counted them out, you're counting out about 50 of them. So this ice in this lower pocket glacier is only 50 years old.
Go on and talk to my viewers.
I think I see actually a trail right down there. So there's that one and there's a couple that roll along here, but that one looks pretty prominent.
Oh yeah.
Should we go down to that one? So look at this, we're right next to the ice here. We'll just keep following this, traversing around. It's really mellowed out, the steepness of the toe of the glacier here. But you can see up here, traveling across these rocks here onto the ice, it's melted all of its snow from last season. So all of the crevasses are exposed and we can navigate pretty well on that.
I hope this rock right here doesn't move and fall on us.
Well, Irina puts her crampons on. I want to show you this cirque here. It's hard to beat places like this. Here's a nice superficial glacial stream. And you can see the water's actually clear up here. Nice, good drinking water. Ready to walk across this glacier?
I am ready for glacier travel.
All right, let's do it. Here's the transition from this last year's snowpack. Right now we're walking on the ice. So all the snowpack from last season is melted. And there's a little left up here.
Yeah, I do it. You should expose me.
I will, here.
Because I'm not scared of
that. Well, look at this black stuff here. All right. I don't know, let's touch it. There's more over here. Yeah, at first it looked like rock, but now it looks like just degraded
wood.
Sure. Yeah.
You can see it right there. Mm-hmm. You can see needles,
yeah,
which falls from way up above up there. This is the layering I was talking about earlier. Yeah. Now you can see it pretty well.
Oh,
typically it's annual layers, but some of them can be storm layers too. Actually right here, it's kind of cool because we've
they
got the open,
ones.
Yeah, we got the open crevasse right here, but as you can see, that line matches up,
yeah,
with the line across the way. I don't know if it's a balloon or, but
it's a balloon.
The number one thing I find on glaciers, yeah, is balloons from people.
Yeah.
Where does the balloons go? Onto the glacier.
Oh, they go
yep. We got the toe of the glacier down here. It'd be nice to get down there, right?
Yeah.
So I think we'll head over this way, circle around and get on the rocks and walk down that slabby rock there. Yeah, definitely experiencing something,
yeah,
experiencing something out of the,
yeah,
normal realm.
Is this real? Is this gonna last forever?
Some glacial striations on here. And this is some of the most recent rock that's been exposed. You're gonna come in here with me and hide underneath the ice. Do it. I just hope it doesn't collapse.
Wow.
The inner workings of the glacier. You should be so lucky. We should be so lucky. All right, we've circled around the terminus of the glacier here. And now we're gonna get down to the terminus, right at the end. And there's one more thing I wanna show you down here is the glacial flower from recent glacial receding, which has been pretty significant over the last 11 years. And you can see right down there. In the last 11 years, the glacier has receded 130 meters. Look at this terrain. We're looking at the warmest part of the day too, so the heaviest melt is going on right now. Hanging by a thread. That's why we're moving fast through here. Everything's moving around here. Here's some glacial flower right here. Mmm, really good for the skin. All right. Thanks for joining us on this Curtis Glacier excursion. We're about to get out of here and get off the ice and we can breathe again. But oh, before, look at this rock right here. Funky.
Yeah. For
for size up, yeah. How does that happen? A variety of ways, and we can't talk about it today because we're getting out of here. It's time to leave. But thanks for joining us.